Time. I can't get enough of this. I'm soaking her up with all of this information now as the Cleveland International Film Festival is in full swing, and one director with long-standing ties here to our city of Cleveland is screening her short film tomorrow night. It's 26 minutes long. Artist and filmmaker Simone Barros joins us now with more on her film. It's called Station Hope, A Conversation. Thank you for being with us today.
Thank you for having me.
I'm so excited for you, and I'm so excited for our city and for this to get out. So yes. First, you have a lot of ties to Cleveland. You have family here. You've been teaching here before.
That's right. That's right. I've taught at the Cleveland Institute of Art. I'll be teaching there this summer. Documentary filmmaking. I've also taught at Cuyahoga Community College.
Sure.
Screenwriting, and that comes from my career working in film and television. But also the Cleveland Public Theater has been a home for me, as well as many artists who are creating, developing work. And so those moments converged into us creating a documentary that's about a one-night theater event that they hold at St. John's Episcopal Church to celebrate the Underground Railroad. St. John's Episcopal Church is one of the few authenticated stops on the Underground Railroad. So to bring all those artists together and have them talk about the legacy of slavery today and how it still presents challenges for our communities is some of the brilliance of that piece and what Cleveland Public Theater does. And so Cleveland Public Theater and Northwater Productions asked me to direct a documentary that somehow encapsulates that, which is a huge challenge.
Right, right? Certainly. So in your research is when you sort of started realizing how important this area was to the Underground Railroad.
Yes, exactly. The, Ohio has one of the most lines that culminate from the southern states because of Ohio's position on Lake Erie, and that Canada is the very next place. Mm-hmm. So St. John's was codenamed on the Underground Railroad Station Hope. Mm-hmm. It was the last station before you crossed the lake. And freedom seekers were hiding in the bell tower waiting for a cue to make it across the lake to freedom.
So many stories. I don't know how you are able to put it into 26 minutes. And the people that helped them and assisted them. It is really, truly such a fascinating historical part of our fabric, of what makes our nation, and especially our area here.
Yes.
How important it was and vital, and the families who really tried to help too.
Yes.
Do you touch on that? Do you have an opportunity to do that?
We do, yes. Look, and exactly as you said, the challenge of entering all these different spaces.
I want to sit there for 5 hours and watch it.
Yes.
Right?
It's true, it's true. And so as a filmmaker, you think about those challenges even before you make the film. And so the idea that came to me, instead of having each of my artists in their own little box and what we call talking head, I thought, let's put them all in conversation together. Let's put them in this sacred space, St. John's, sacred because of the church, but also sacred because of the people whose lives changed by going through there, the blood that is consecrating the land. And let's have them in this space where they also do the performance, which that was Cleveland Public Theater, who does site-specific theater, and let them talk and let them explore this. So in their conversation, they talk about everything from the Underground Railroad to the Huff riots that occurred here in Cleveland, to immigrants that are migrating from Mexico, because all of these are likened stories. They speak to each other, even though they're not exactly the same story. So the artists really were wonderful in their candor and their honesty. It becomes quite an emotional film because you really come to understand how much they put into it when they think about making this work. And so as a filmmaker, you want to match the content to the form. And I think this is one of those films that really seeks that and hits it very
well. What would you like to see happen with your film?
Yes, I would like for the film to really gain exposure to Cleveland Public Theater, which is already such a known and such a wonderful theater that in the theater world, nationally, it's recognized as creating dynamic work, as giving voice to diversity and diverse works in form, as well as diversity of the artists.
Could this go into other film festivals?
Yes, yes. We're hoping that there's a wonderful film festival, Chagrin Documentary Film
Festival. Oh, that's a great
We're
one
hoping.
Too. Yes.
We've just applied, so we'll find out whether we're accepted there. But we're hoping it'll screen there, and we're hoping that it'll screen a few other places.
Well, it's an emotional journey, and an educational one, historical too. Yes. Thank you so much for bringing light to this and sharing this incredible experience. Yes. And so much of Cleveland's in it with the actors and the location. Yes. And
yeah, the timing is really right because the film screens tomorrow,
right?
April 4th, and then Station Hope is a month later, May 4th. Oh. At St. John's Episcopal, one night only event. Both of these are one night only events. So it's a nice, you know, month of celebrating this history.
Check it out. We really thank you so much for taking the time to come in and share this with us.
Oh,
thank
you.
It looks fascinating. I can't wait to see it, Stephanie.
It looks
beautiful. So again, you can see it tomorrow night at 9:20 in the evening at Tower City Cinemas. Check it out. It's always a great film festival too. And good luck to you.
Yes, thank you.
That's great. All right, we're gonna take a short break. We will be back with more on Fox 8 News in the morning. Stay close.